yeah.
All right, everybody. This is the Bowtie Boss. Again, no bowtie today because I'm here for Sammy Horowitz's fight, and I was going to do a lot of screaming. I want my neck all constricted.
I don't blame you.
Again, I have to say this every video. The best in the business. You guys just saw this guy at Mayweather and Golden Boy Promotions.
Yes, absolutely.
The Mayday or Mayhem or May whatever.
Yeah, it was. It was a weekend full of a lot of Mays. It was Mayhem. It was Maidana. And it was Floyd Money Mayweather looking outstanding. But we were here for Hitz Boxing here tonight. What a night of action, Bowtie Boss.
Absolutely. So, speaking of a night of action.
Yes.
I mean, the last fight with Antonio Canas.
Yes.
I mean, it ended on a cut, but up until that point. Yes. How good was that fight?
It was a fight that was really, it was marinating. See, I like to eat a good steak. And this fight was marinating. They were putting the seasoning on it. They put it on the grill. And it was marinating. I could smell how good it was going to be. And then the cut stopped it. And we didn't get it. It was like, it didn't even get to rare. It's just blah.
So
I was just like, man, it was so good. It was marinating. It was cooking.
Speaking of putting that seasoning on,
yes.
I saw a couple of solid left hooks that put Canas down to a knee.
Yes.
I mean, from your perspective, did you think he was even getting up at that?
I was surprised. But you know what, though? I'll be honest with you. I've seen Antonio Canas' entire career, whether it be MMA or boxing, all of his fights. And I'm not surprised he got up. But what I'm surprised about is that he didn't hold. This guy will go through fire. He'll go through brimstone. He'll go through 120-degree weather in the Las Vegas desert with no water for 3 days and will still keep fighting. This man doesn't stop. He keeps coming forward, and he has that bravado, that tenacity, and he'll get hit by 7 or 8, and he'll clip you with one, and that one, guess what? 99. Good night. That's what it is. And he believed that he could do that tonight.
Now, speaking of that one, there was an exchange early. I think it was the first round, maybe halfway through.
Yeah.
Caught him with a right hand. I thought it was a knockdown his glove touch.
That's what I thought.
I thought that shit was over then.
Listen, I'm going to tell you this. I like Kurt Spivey a lot, but guess what? There's a reason why I wear contacts and I don't drive on the road without having any additional glasses or contacts. Guess what? Maybe some contacts, maybe some glasses or whatever, maybe some LASIK surgery, because that was a knockdown, and that was not a headbutt. That was a punch. I asked the referee, or I asked Hernandez, not once, but twice, followed it up. All I needed to do was ask him 3 questions. He said the cut was caused by a punch. So I don't know why it wasn't a technical knockout. That's the way it is. That's the way he sliced it and diced it. But what I do know is what a night of action. What a battle with Nick Asbury, Ricardo Chavez, Sam Horowitz, the Russian concussion.
Yeah.
28 seconds. The man didn't even work 10 seconds or 20 seconds. 10 seconds were spent counting. 28 seconds. Let's break that down for you mathematicians out there. That's 18 seconds of work with the 10-second additional with the knockout. Sam Horowitz, that's a bad man.
And they didn't even touch gloves for about 3 seconds.
Nope. Exactly.
There, right?
So you would be like, all right, so let's do more math. 15 seconds of work for Sam Horowitz.
Gotcha.
That's what it was. What I do know, though, 2 days after Thanksgiving, we're talking about numbers, 2 days after Thanksgiving, as you're running around, you're shopping, you're having turkey, guess what? Come to the Horseshoe Casino for Hitz Boxing.
That's right.
The Bowtie Boss will be here.
I will definitely
and I don't know if he's going to be screaming or not, but he's going to be looking with a damn good shirt like this. Stop making me look bad. And then I'll have my bow tie on. I promise you, I'll give you a bow tie for Thanksgiving. It's a holiday season. Maybe I'll give you a little red for Christmas time and the holidays. I'll be very cheery and bring you some festive cheer. So will the Boxing Inside the Ring. Hitz Boxing on Saturday, November 29. Check it out.
Now, I might not even have a voice because November 15th, Bellator 131.
That's true. Ill Will Brooks, hey, I'll tell you what. I love Ill Will Brooks. I did a lot of it, and I'm a little disappointed, but I am glad that he has the Bellator staff taking care of him announcing-wise. But man, oh man, Chandler and Will Brooks, I'm getting excited, I'm getting amped up, I'm getting revved up, cannot wait. The season finale, so you got Tito and Bonner to go ahead and highlight that, but I'm going to tell you this, don't even waste your time on that main event. The real main event is Ill Will Brooks for the strap, defending his title for the first time against Michael Chandler. That's going to be a battle. It's going to be what Canas and Hernandez were supposed to be. Believe you that, and like my good friend says, I'm trying to tell you, this is going to be a fight of the year candidate. You're going to see a lot of ba 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 and a lot of bing, 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 as Obsky says. Expect that on November 15th with Bellator with Ill Will Brooks.
All right, so I'm going to start a petition right now. Who wants to see Ray Flores after a couple drinks announcing the next fight.
I'm not even on one yet.
For that one.
I'm not even on one yet.
Yeah.
I'm not even
He's just high on fights and high
I'm just
on
high on life.
Tonight.
You know what I mean? Loving it. Very thankful to work for the greatest companies in the world, and Bobby Hitz and Hitz Boxing. The entire staff certainly at the top of the heap.
Yeah,
always a pleasure to see the bow tie
Ray
boss,
Flores,
even
bow
if
tie
it's
boss.
Without the bow tie.